How many times have you brushed them now?
74. Still, at least everyone is back to normal and I've erased all their memories. Oh, I think I found a bit of your dad's dentures.
I've come to say goodbye. Dr. Crispin's coming for me soon and he's told me to get packed. So, we have.
Oh, Tyler.
I'll be okay, but Andromeda doesn't want to go, so I wondered if you could look after her. You'll be safe there, Andromeda.
Yes, take a seat, Andromeda. But actually, Tyler, I think you might all be staying.
Mistress?
Yesterday afternoon, I got Stanley and Ella to visit Dr. Crispin at his home.
Why, oh, Minty Breath One?
To show him their amazing superpowers. And he agreed to put them on his live TV show.
But how's that going to help me? It'll just make Dr. Crispin look fantastic.
I don't think so, Tyler.
Good morning. And welcome to my own live show, Crispin. And not before time. And for my first show, I'd like to introduce two astonishingly special guests. Ella and Stanley Dawkins. Why don't you tell the viewers why you're here?
Not a clue.
No, the car just came and picked us up.
Ella and Stanley are here because they're not simply patients from my surgery. No, they're humans with amazing powers. Humans who can actually fly. I know this because yesterday I saw them flying around my living room. And viewers, they're going to fly for you now.
He then asked his bemused guests to belch fire and lift him up with one finger. The program was rapidly pulled off the air and Dr. Crispin taken to hospital for psychiatric tests. Oh, it's sad when people go bonkers like that.
Yeah, we think so too.
When Daddy sucked the powers out of Granny and Grandpa, did he suck anything else?
What do you mean?
Gotta go. Some Amazonian peasants are trapped in rising floodwaters. Nope. It's okay.
Why, they're safe?
No, they're peasants, Janet. You've got to have some standards.
See what I mean?
I think I'll take in a round of golf instead.
George has decided to run for mayor.
This is my formidable opponent in the race to be mayor.
Mrs. Raven is running Piers' campaign.
And if I know her, she's going to fight dirty, toad-faced.
Vote for me.
Vote for me.
Vote for me.
Thanks, Peter.
Hello, little Ollie.
No! Mr. Disgracing. Did him up with a loose woman.
You're so wrapped up in your political campaign, you haven't got time for me and Ollie. She's left me. She tried to warn me and I didn't listen. But now I've lost her. She's gone forever.